This is the entrance to Hannah Hall, where the murals by Harvey Johnson were located, or are located, underneath the overpaint.
Said that the murals were painted out because there was flaking and they were unsightly upon entering the building. You can see, in fact, the texture of the walls where the original texture of the mural was, but then there were large areas that are now smoothed over that you can see that were spackled. And in fact, you can see that this entire area, the width of my hand, was all spackled down the wall. This area here looks like it was missing original paint. So not only will we have to remove original paint from the surface of the mural, but we're also going to have to remove all this spackling that was applied to the wall to cover over areas that had flaked. All right, this solvent eats into the paint very slowly and really isn't appropriate for removing the white paint off the surface. It's way too slow. However, it might be perfect for taking off the residual paint once we get closer to the original mural. So it might be something we can use later, but not to start the project. All right, so the next test is a special product, special concoction that won't dissolve everything perfectly immediately, but could cause things to swell very nicely, and then we can rub them off before it starts attacking the original paint. So you're not going to see anything on the video here immediately. Actually, it looks like it's working pretty good, pretty quickly. See what this little test does, and then I'll bring you back after something starts to happen. So after we put the gel on the surface, I'm putting a layer of plastic over the top to let it kind of percolate and work its magic, and then we'll see it peel off here in a minute. So let's test it. And you know, looks like the white paint is coming off. I think I'm gonna let it sit for just another second, another minute or two. Okay, a few more minutes have passed, and I can see the mural starting to reappear below. See the white paint coming off, and you can see I've got it here on my stick also. So I'm gonna wipe it off now, and then we'll take some of that solvent that didn't seem to work before and see where that takes us. Thank you. Well, we're definitely seeing the mural, of course. Question is, are we starting to get any of the mural off with it? At this point, I'm not sure. But that's why we're doing tests. So you can see here that the mural paint is starting to show through. And in order to push my hand and stress the original paint and see what the limitations are, I very quickly went through that paint and have gone into the wall. So this method could be a little too strong as far as getting the white paint off the mural without damaging the mural. So I've got something else here I'm going to try. And we'll give this moment to see how safe the process is. By the way, the process that I'm going through, we went through when we uncovered thousands of square acres, thousands of square feet, what seemed like acres, of overpaint off of murals at Fair Park. You can see some of that project at fairparkmurals.com. So as you can see here, I've taken another solvent, which causes the top stuff to roll up and rub off like latex rubber. And that's going in the right direction. You can see that's coming off, and there's paint there. And that kind of action looks like it might work over on this part too. I've tried this second solvent solution. I haven't let this one sit as long because of the problems that this solvent had. But I can see that this system of putting on a solvent, letting it swell, and then use something to gum it up again and roll it off like a gummy substance, and not really try to dissolve it off, but just kind of swell it and then roll off the sticky stuff, is probably going to be the action that's going to be required to get this paint off safely. Yeah, it looks like we're going in the right direction. And with letting this sit a little bit more, you can see that second test is starting to gum up and roll off also. Interesting. And now with a little bit more patience, you can see that all of a sudden that can be encouraged off like a layer of rubber paint. That's kind of cool. If any of you out there love peeling sunburns, why don't you give me a call? I can hire you. You'll probably love this work. Yeah, that's very interesting. You can see here, now that I've done a few other tests, I'm waiting for these areas to gum up and peel off. Working its magic. And this is a test that I'm doing to peel off the paint rather than rub it off. and I'm getting good results with that too. But this is going to take more time than you want to sit around and watch. Hey, fast breaking news here. You can see that this test all of a sudden rendered some good results. Not exactly what I want to do yet, but you can see that that's the mural showing through. And we're going to do a great job in revealing it and restoring it, bringing it back to its former glory. Just like peeling skin off of a sunburn.
I promise to make this blog interesting. I'll make more videos, put interesting photographs on it, and keep the articles flowing, so stay plugged in. An action that you can take right away would be to sign up for the RSS feeds. That would update you every time we add to the blog. Also, if you will, if you like our videos and our articles, click on the thumbs up and like them so that it can spread the word to other people.